Hi guys, in this video we are going to assemble the Batman utility belt from the Batman v Superman movie, and you can see how I made each individual part in my previous part videos. This is the final part, final assembly and reveal. So first thing we're going to do is attach the buckle. In fact, first of all, I'm going to show you the strap. I bought this off eBay for a couple of pounds. It is a buckle belt, and the way we're going to attach everything, first of all, you want to obviously get it to your waist size, and then once you have it to your waist size, lay it out as so, measure the length and find the middle. I'm not sure if this looks short on the camera, but as you can see there, I made a line with a pen for the center. That way you can make sure that everything's centered, so that when you wrap it around and put the buckle will be on the center of your back, and then obviously on the other side will be the center, will be where the front will be. So you will buckle this around the back, so that's the center there. So this is the buckle, and what I'm going to do is line up the center of the mat there with the center of the buckle and put it into place. So that's the first step. So that's the buckle now glued in place. Next, the canisters, and again I'm going to put a thin strip of super glue down the center, glue it into place, and then what I'll be doing after that is I'll turn it over. I'll have two little screws and I'll screw in through the back of the belt into the actual wood itself, and that'll keep it secure. Not permanently on, obviously I've put two screws in the back to make sure they stay in place. But next comes the pouches, one on either side, like so. And in the movie, the Batfleck belt, the pouches actually don't sit flush next to each other, they actually raise up slightly, like so. That's what I'll be doing. I'll attach them again with super glue, like so. And then I've got an extra canister that'll go on the end. So that's the next step, let's get them in place. that's everything now glued to the belt. I'm going to leave it to dry, and then I will flip the belt over and put two small self-tapping screws into the cylinders to secure them on, and then I will also put some split pins there into the back of the belt through the pre-drilled holes in the pouches, which will secure them on as well. And that is the next step.
So the final step to secure the pouches is to put some split pins through the belt at the back, as you can see there, through the pre-drilled holes in the pouches. Insert a split pin, which will help it secure in place. And that is solid now. With the glue and the split pins, that's solid. So let's do the rest of them. That's the split pins in, securing the pouches in place. Last thing I have to do is put two screws into the canisters, there, there and there, and then that'll be the belt complete. Just flip it over. In fact, it won't be complete because the last thing I have to do actually is put a few scratches I've noticed on the screen movie used belt. There's a few battle damage on the buckle, so once that's done, that'll be the Batflex utility belt complete, ready for the final reveal.
belt complete, I've gone ahead and done the battle scars, the battle damage on the buckle. I did this by scoring marks into the buckle itself with just a knife, and then I used some dark brown paint just to dry brush onto the scars themselves or the scratches, just to make them pop out a little bit. So that is now everything secure. Just flick it over. So the canisters are screwed in. The pouches are secured in with glue and split pins, as you can see. Everything's secure, and I've actually run out of black paint, but I went ahead and coloured the inside of the pouches with some just a black Sharpie pen, just in the pouches themselves, just so it doesn't, when you open them, it's not obviously gold. So that is now the belt complete, and is extremely light. The heaviest thing on the belt itself is probably the dowels, because the pouches are really light. That's just made out of plastic and card. The strap is really thin and light as well, so it's brilliant for cosplaying, and actually you can actually use it as well, so you can put things in it, like your money, or if you've got a small enough mobile, possibly put a mobile in there. So yeah, time for the reveal.